Alô? Jesus Christ. We want to apologize to the community for making noise for you this afternoon. We are bringing you good news, and we're going to bring this good news through songs and also words of encouragement. I know you are busy in your places, you are busy in your shops, you are busy in your houses. We just want a few minutes of your time. We won't be long, very short. We are here to encourage you. We are living in very difficult times. We are living in times of uncertainty. We are living in times where many of us have lost hope. We are living in times where many of us have lost our jobs. We are living in times where many of us have lost our loved ones. Many of our loved ones have died and passed on. We are living in times where many of us are sick. We are living in times where many of us are disappointed by so many things. And we are here today just to come and encourage you. And we are coming to tell you that don't lose courage, don't lose hope. We are inviting you to participate as we continue with this song service. Thank you. We're going to sing a song right now, and then, yeah, as we continue.
Number 9, Jesus is coming again.
Lift up the trumpet and now let it ring. Jesus is coming again. Cheer up the pilgrims, be joyful and sing. Jesus is coming again. Coming again. Coming again. Jesus is coming again. Every hilltop proclaim it in praise. Jesus is coming again. Coming in glory, the Lamb that was slain. Jesus is coming again. Coming again. Coming again, Jesus is coming again. Sounding of ocean in each mighty wave, Jesus is coming again. Curl the thunder of the shore that he led, Jesus is coming again. Coming again, Jesus is coming again. Hearing the bells that last one in God, Jesus is coming again. Tempest and wind waves and anthem prolonged, Jesus is coming again. Nations are angry, by this we do know, Jesus is coming again. No legend Christmas men run to and fro, Jesus is coming again. Coming again, coming again, Jesus is coming again.
Number 2. Number 2. The coming king. The coming king. Number 2.
The coming king is at the door.
Take up all our things and go. Who allowed us in the first place?
The owner of the show.
Very carefully.
Yeah, let's.
We can't just. Or is the tenant that are not
there? Yeah.
Not a problem. Me, I'm still hungry. I am very hungry. Sorry. I'm very hungry.
Not a problem.
Those who can't make it, me, I'm going to Ravensfield there. Those where we stay. I'm sorry, ne? Those who can't make it,
I would understand, but even if it's you, I'm going to.
And love and gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you at this moment in time, dear God. We thank you for the challenges that you bring, dear God, for the strengthen our faith in you. We ask now as we move to the rest of the nation, dear God, will you be with us? Move with us, dear God, and give us safeguards and mercies, and we will be with us. We will be with the very good ministry and the people that have heard the small impact very well, dear God, and you will be the after teacher. And may you stay in this community and bless it, dear God. Bless each and every person here this afternoon, dear God, and may you be with us, be within our hearts. Don't leave us, dear God, don't forsake us. It's my humble prayer in Christ Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen.
Alright, so I'll understand those who can't make it, but it's not a force for everyone. No? But you are.
News, not bad news. That is the fear for Slechtenis. Switch on your radio, that's Slechtenis. Switch on your TV, Slechtenis. It's high time we receive good news. I'm inviting everyone in Ravensfield to join us in this service. We are here to worship the Lord. Wherever you are in your houses, come and join us as we worship the Lord. Let's sing another song, a song that will end. That song, eh?
We are marching over to Jerusalem. We are marching over to Jerusalem.
Amen. Amen.
You want me? This brother wants us to repeat this song.
Let's go.
Jerusalem.
The song is finished now. Now we have to sing a hymn, eh? We have to sing a hymn right now. A nice hymn that will uplift us. Nice hymn, eh? A nice hymn. Yeah. One we all know, eh? A song that is very nice that will uplift us. Let's sing a hymn. And we're going to give our brother to share a word for us. That's the word of encouragement.
Number 34.
Let us go and praise the Lord. Let us go.
This brother is going to encourage us for 10 minutes. 10 minutes, my friend.
What a mighty God we serve.
Amen. Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time. That's right, guys. God is good. And you know, one day God is coming again. We have this hope. And this is the hope that burns within our hearts. And with this hope is in your heart, the only thing you can do with this hope is to share with others. God said we must go and share the good thing that the Lord is doing for us each and every day. You might be wondering why, what is so good about God? Well, the fact that you are here today, the fact that you are breathing, the fact that you woke up this morning, the fact that you're seeing the clouds, you're seeing the trees, it means that God is good. You know, God is so good that even if you hate God, He's still going to put His sunshine on you. God is still going to provide water for you. You can love God, you can hate God. God will forever love you. And that is our hope that we can have. Your family might desert you. Your brothers, your sisters, your uncles, your mothers, whoever, they can forsake you. But God says one thing. God says, I will never leave you, nor forsake you. He says, cast all your cares upon me because I care for you. Guys, God is good. And all the time. Before there was the clouds was Ish, there was sunshine behind those clouds, as you can see. And it was a very beautiful sight. And to me, that is just proof that there's someone up there who is controlling everything. Alright, our world is sick, guys. We cannot ignore the fact that our world is sick. We're seeing terrible things happening. People are dying, earthquakes are happening everywhere. People are asking, is God still there? Is God still caring? There's only one thing, God is still in control. God is still in control. If you turn our Bibles to John 14 verse 1, John 14 verse 1 says, let not your heart be troubled. Let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in God, also believe in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it was not so, I would have told you. I will go and prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and receive you unto myself. And so that where I am, there you may also be. Guys, God is good. God has gone to heaven to prepare a place for us in heaven. If you go back to history, we see that this world was doomed. Once upon a time, this world was perfect. Perfection was flourishing everywhere. The trees, the skies, the seas, and everything was good. Everything was good. God created this world and he said, everything is good. He says, this is good. But if you look at this world today, it is not good. It is not good. And this is not the world that God created in the beginning. The world in the beginning was, we cannot imagine what the world in the beginning was. But because of sin, this world started breaking down. Because of sin, we started being smaller. Because of sin, diseases started increasing in our world. Because of sin, we started killing each other. Because of sin, we stopped caring about each other. But one thing is that God is still in control. God is still in control. Well, we're living in the last days these days, as we all know. This world has a limit. Before this world was created, God had set a limit on this world. If you turn our Bible to the book of Job 14 verse 5, someone's going to read Job 14 verse 5 for me. God made limits for this earth, and once the limit of this earth is passed, we can no longer be here. And that is the hope that we can have, because God wants us to prepare. Because once time has run out, then it's finished. Job 14 verse 5.
Job chapter 14 verse 5. Seeing his days are determined, the number of his months are with thee. Thou hast appointed his bounds that he cannot pass.
God has appointed the bounds for this earth. This earth has a limit, and once that limit is reached, it cannot pass. Let's go to Acts 17 verse 25 and 26. Acts 17 verse 25 and 26.
Thou he needed anything, seeing he giveth all life and breath and all things. In verse 26, and hath made of one blood all nations of men, for to dwell on all the face of the earth, and hath determined the times before appointed, and the bounds of their habitation.
Okay. God, before he created this world, he said, at a certain time, this world is going to end. It's going to finish. You know, since God knows when the world is going to end, Satan also knows when the world is going to end. Let us say to Revelation 12 as well, that devil knows when this world is going to end.
Okay.
Revelation 12 as well.
Bye-bye.
Revelation 12 as well. Therefore rejoice ye heavens, and you that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you and in great wrath, because he knows that he had but a short time.
The devil knows that he had a short time on this earth. So now, since the devil knows that he has a short time, God is warning us, woe unto the inhabitants of the earth, because the devil knows he has but a short time on this earth. So the devil is going to do anything he can in order to deceive us and take us off the path on focusing on God. Matthew 8, verse 28.
Chapter 8, verse 28. Okay, verse 28. And when he was come to the other side into the country of... Okay, I understand. They met him two possessed with devils, coming out of the tombs, exceeding fierce, so that no man might pass by that way. Verse 39. And behold, they cried, saying, What have we to do with thee, Jesus, Son of God? And art thou come here to torment us at the time? Verse 30. And there was a good way.
Thank you. You see, the demons even know when this world is going to end, my brothers and my sisters. This is when Jesus was walking, and as he's walking, two possessed men meet Jesus, and they say, Jesus, what have you to do with us? Are you here to torment us before thy time has come? So we think that the demons even know when the world is going to end. Now, do you think Jesus wants us to know when the world is going to end? Jesus definitely wants us to know when this world is going to end. He has given a sign of the time, and he says, when you see these things happening, know that I am coming. If you go to Matthew 24, the Bible says, there's going to be famine, there's going to be pestilences, there's going to be bad things in this world. And when you see these things, know that my coming is near, it's even at the door. So who are we in this world when we see these things happening? Who are we to say, no, Jesus is not coming yet? If you read Matthew 28, 24, verse 9, it says, Matthew 24, verse 9.
Yeah. Then shall they deliver you out of...
Verse 8.
All these are the beginnings of sorrows.
Yeah.
When Jesus says, when you see earthquakes, when you see pestilence, when you see bad things happening, know that these are the beginning of sorrows. I'm not here to tell you, my brothers and my sisters, that we've seen all these things in the year 2020. And with no shadow of a doubt, we can say that 2020 was the beginning of the end of the world. We cannot deceive you, my brothers and my sisters. Jesus is coming soon, and he wants us to prepare. Now, Jesus did not leave us alone. He gave us the signs of the times. And when we see the signs of the times, we need to start preparing. Jesus gave us warnings and Jesus gave us a preparation message. So that when we see these things happening, we need to start preparing. Revelation 14, verse 6 says, And I saw an angel flying in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel, to preach unto them that dwell upon the earth, to every nation, to every tongue, kingdom, and people, saying with a loud voice, Fear God and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment has come, and worship him who has made heavens and the earth, the sea, and the springs of water. My brothers and my sisters, it's time that we fear God. It's time that we turn away from our evil ways. It's time that we turn to God and repent of our sins and believe in the gospel. With these few words, my brothers and my sisters, I'd just like to tell you to prepare yourself and repent and believe in Jesus Christ, because Jesus is coming soon. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. What do we say?
Amen.
I don't hear you at all. What do we say to the Lord?
Amen.
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 Now let's sing a song.
This opportunity to greet you, dear friends, in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. I'll just continue where my brother started. It says, let not your heart be troubled.
Yes, sir.
You believe in God, believe also in me.
Yes, sir.
In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Now my question is, dear friends, does it take 2,000 years for Jesus to do heavenly construction? If Christ created the whole universe in 6 days, or it took him 24 hours, He laid the earth to its fruition, and he said, it is all good.
Yes, sir.
It has been 2,000 years, and Christ had said, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. And I want to propose this to you, that Christ has not taken 2,000 years busy doing heavenly construction. We hear from Hebrews that, for we have, it says, for we have not an high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. So we find that Christ left the disciples saying, do not be troubled. I go prepare a place for you. And this place that he is preparing is not mentioned. For he is saying in that same verse that the mansions are already in heaven. His Father's house is big enough. So I want to say to you that Christ is in heaven preparing a place for you and me that we may be able to access heaven one day. And he stands there as our high priest, having felt what we go through when we lose our loved ones, when we go through troublous times, different and diverse temptations. Christ has walked the same path as we are, but yet without sin. So this is the problem, dear friends. Christ has gone up to heaven as a high priest to take care of this problem of sin, that he may be able to remove sin from his people, to prepare them and get them ready for heaven. Hebrews 6 verse 4 says, for it is impossible for those who were once enlightened, that is those who have tasted the heavenly gift and were made partakers of the Holy Ghost and have tasted the good word of God and the powers of the world to come. So this part is saying, it is impossible for those who have walked the path of Christianity, who have had communion with God. Before COVID, we went to our churches. We prayed and had communion with God. We shared the words of the gospel. We partook of God's power. This Christ gave and did on our behalf. And now, here Paul is saying, it is impossible for those who have gone through this experience. If they shall fall away, that is, if they apostatize, if they leave God and turn their backs from God, it becomes impossible to renew them again unto repentance. Seeing they crucify to themselves the Son of God afresh, and put him to an open shame. The Bible says, if we continue to sin whilst we know, there is no more sacrifice left for us. So Christ is in heaven, being a high priest, standing on our behalf between God and humankind, trying by all means, asking them to come back to him, to come back to the throne boldly, confessing their sin and leaving it there for him to take care of it, to turn back and turn away from sin, that he may be able to give them access to get into heaven. That is what Christ is doing for us, dear friends. That is the preparation that Christ is doing for us in heaven. So when he says to his disciples, I go to my Father's house, do not be troubled.
Yes, sir.
And you know the way, because Philip asks, where are you going? Christ says, you know the way. And the way is to keep God's commandments. Christ says, if you love me, keep my commandments.
Yes, sir.
Abide in my love by keeping the commandments, just as I have abided in my Father's love, and I kept his commandments. By doing so, we will be able to turn away from sin, and Christ will be able to finish his work of preparing the place for us. As I draw to a close, Christ continues to say in John 14, for so long, they had been so attached to Jesus, they knew his power, but they started longing for his presence. And now he says, I am leaving, and they now are distressed. And he says to them, peace I leave with you.
Yes, sir.
My peace I give unto you.
Yes, sir.
Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. He continues to say, you have heard how I said unto you, I go away and come again unto you. If ye loved me, ye would rejoice, because I said, I go unto my Father. For my Father is greater than I. And now I have told you before it come to pass, that when it is come to pass, ye might believe. Dear friends, Christ has told us everything that was to come to pass. We are living in these troublous times, and we feel it. Our bodies groan, and we long for a better place. When we suffer and lose our dear friends, when we hear shootings night and day, morning and evening, shootings left, right and center, then we know that it is sooner than before. Christ is soon to come, but there is a preparation that must be done. We must get rid of our sins. And Christ says, my peace I leave unto you. And it is Christ's peace that will be able to carry us into heaven. There is no other peace that we can find but in Christ. In Jesus' name, I pray and preach unto you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We are almost there now. We are about to close now. We are almost there. Our services are very short. Our services are very short. Now we're going to sing the book of 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 7. The Bible says, the end of all things is at hand. The end of an alles is now bay. And because the end of everything is close, the Bible says, be sober. Yes, master. And watch unto prayer. If there was a time we needed to pray, it is now. We need prayer now more than ever. We need Jesus now more than ever. Let's sing that stanza, and then I'll give my brother here to close the service for us. He's gonna close for us. He's the last man here. Amen.
Yeah.
My fellow brothers and sisters, it is now high time to believe the gospel, for the time is fulfilled.
Yes, sir.
The time is at hand. It is high time, my brothers and sisters, to come back home. We have wandered far away from home. And I want to tell you tonight, yes, there are those who are going to be saved in the midst of this trials. In the darkest world we are living today, people are asking questions. Is it possible that in heaven's feet will be found people who are faithful, people who shall be saved? I want to tell you tonight, yes, there are people in heaven's feet,
yes,
who are going to make it to heaven one day.
Amen.
It is high time, my brothers and sisters, to believe the gospel. The time is at hand. Jesus is coming again.
Yes, sir.
The time is now to confess our sins. The time is now to repent as we appear for closing this service.
Yes, sir.
We want to pray with someone tonight who says, I'm tired of living this life.
Yes, sir.
I'm tired of drugs.
Yes, sir.
I'm tired of prostitution. I have squandered all my property working for the devil. I want to come back home, home sweet home. Tonight we are saying, home sweet home.
Yes, sir.
This is what we're doing. Hey. Where's another one?
My dear friends,
home is coming tonight. Jesus, we want to make a commitment with someone tonight. None of us will make it to heaven.
Yes,
I can tell you, we are surrounded by disaster. We are surrounded by terror. Each and every day, people are crying. We witness bloodshed. Wherever we are, our feet are not soft. We are not, we cannot walk around. We are scared of our family. Friends, children are scared of their fathers. Mothers are scared of their husbands. This is the world we are living today. And people are asking a question. Who is going to make it?
Hey.
I want to tell you tonight that even you, you can make it to heaven.
Yes, sir.
Jesus is stretching out his hands, reaching out for those who are hungry for salvation.
Yes, sir.
Salvation has come to this place tonight. Jesus is calling again. Are you ready? Are you sure you do not want Jesus? Are you sure you are right without God? Are you sure you can make it without God? God wants to offer an opportunity for someone to be saved tonight. The Bible says, let not your heart be troubled. Jesus knew that in 2020, people will be troubled, especially here in the street. And Jesus says, let not your heart be troubled. All you need to do is to believe. Believe in God. Believe in Jesus. He is offering the best solution for your life. Jesus is coming again, my dear brothers and sisters. as we come close, about to close this service, we don't want to close someone outside the grace of God. For God has stretched his hands, he's calling for everyone. Whoever is willing, come, that says Jesus. Come unto me, all who are heavy laden and labor, I will give you rest. You are tired, my sister. You cannot take it anymore. Your children are disobedient. They are all hooked up in drugs. You do not know what to do. The pipe of Christ. Let not your heart be troubled. He said, if you are being abused, Jesus says, do not be troubled. The solution, believe. Believe in God. Believe also in me. For in my father's house, there are many mansions. I want to tell you something tonight. Your mansion is there.
Yes, sir.
Your mansion is there in heaven. Don't look down upon yourself. You know, I'm going to go to Luke 19, verse 8. The Bible says, for Jesus, he came to seek and to save that which is lost. Let me tell you, dear friends, Jesus is interested in hunting for a sinner.
Yes, sir.
He is seeking for those who are lost deep in sin. He is calling them tonight. He wants to make an appointment with you. Jesus is not playing games. He might think that it's fun. You know, preaching the gospel, it must end up, we must end up like crazy people. It seems like we have nothing to do. That's why we squander our time doing this. Let me tell you, my friends. There was a crusade in Soto. Only overnight, for one evening, a crusade was run in Soto. But out of the crusade, four people were saved. I can tell you tonight, you can be one of the people to be saved tonight. It might be too late for tomorrow. And I can tell you, maybe you might not see tomorrow again. So what you're going to do before we pray? The Lord has an appointment with you. Jesus came to seek and to save that which is lost. Jesus did not come to call the righteous. For the righteous means that you don't deserve ya. But he came for those who were the outcast in the community. Those who were prostitutes, Mary Magdalene, the murderers, Paul, those who were thieves, sinners. He came to call the sinners to salvation. Do not let this opportunity pass. Let me tell you, young man, I know you are wasting your time in drugs. You are part of the gangsters. I can tell you tonight, if you can make it to heaven. Grace is not close for you. Once again, another opportunity tonight. God wants to speak to you. Come back to Jesus. There is a better place. There's a mansion for you. Life of this world is coming to an end. Why don't you try Jesus?
Yes,
now let me tell you something before I close. Jesus is seeking. If you ask yourself a question, why Jesus is hiding, yet he is God, we see it everywhere. The problem is, the lost do not realize that they are lost. Those who are lost in sin do not even realize that they are lost. Because in our lostness, we are paying school fees for our children. In our lostness, we are putting bread on the table. In our lostness, we become great men and women in this world. But Jesus says, I have come to set you free. In order for you to be free, you realize, he must remember first that you are lost. The reason why salvation is passing by, it is because people think they do not need salvation. People think they are happy without God. It is God's duty to remind you that you are not right without me. I am your Savior. Jesus wants to save someone tonight. My dear friends, let me make an appeal. Wherever you are in the house, wherever you are walking in the street, Jesus has come to seek and to save. And the problem we are facing today, a sinner is running away from the Savior. Giving a Savior an unnecessary work to run after you so that he can drag you from death. It was not necessary for Jesus to go through whatever he went through because of you and me. We were simply supposed to just remember that we are sinners, need a Savior, instead of the Savior to run after us, pleading with us, saying, come my son, come my daughter, I know things are going wrong, are not going wrong with you. You cannot do it alone, but we choose to run away from the Savior. Is there someone tonight who says, I'm tired of my children. I'm tired of living this abusive life. Yes, it would have happened that day you could have died. But God spared your life for tonight. Because God wants to make an appointment with you. Someone must be saved tonight. If you think no one will go to heaven, I can tell you tonight, there are people who will go to heaven. It's a matter of decision whether you will go or not. But I plead with you tonight that lift up your hearts, lift up your heads, for your redemption has drawn nigh. Jesus wants to make a change in your heart. For whoever comes in contact with Christ will never be the same again. It might be drugs. You are telling yourself, I cannot quit it. Maybe you have tried for some time and you have failed. Maybe this prostitution, you are afraid that you cannot pay school fees anymore if you quit prostitution. I want to tell you, there is a better way for you. God did not get you. No, your existence is not by chance, but it is by design and purpose. Yes, sir. Do not limit God in your life. Yes, sir. Come to Jesus as we pray tonight. You may raise your hands, yes, you may come closer, or you may kneel in your house. Yes, God sees everywhere. Yes, sir. Tonight there's someone who says, this life of sin, I'm tired. Yes, sir. I cannot do it anymore. You are about to give up. Sometimes you did not want to hear anymore about God. You thought God does not exist. Because the situation you are can testify that if the Redeemer was alive, I was not supposed to go through this. But I want to tell you tonight, there are problems that we face in life which draws us closer to God.
Yes, sir.
God wants to create a new heart in you. Wherever you are, you need to give God a chance tonight as you are going to wrap up. You know, this time is a witness. One day, God will ask you, have a new head. It is today, the day that will judge us. But salvation has come to this area. I'm going to give up to my elder to pray here.
Yes.
As you prepare your heart, as you're going to pray, do not let trespass.
Yes.
A sinner like you, it is the reason why Jesus died.
Hey.
Jesus died for people like you. Come join us. Lift up your heart. Open your heart. Do not harden your heart. Give Jesus another chance. Yes. As my brother's going to pray, pray in your heart. Tell God everything. Wherever you need power, this gospel is a source of power to salvation and to all those who believe. Yes. He might be saved tonight. May the Lord bless us. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we come to you tonight. We thank you for the opportunity you have given us to listen to your voice. We have heard your voice today. You have spoken to us. You have given us hope. You have given us courage. You have given us strength. And today we can say, we are ready to face tomorrow in a special way. Please, dear Jesus, listen to our cries. Listen to our prayers. You said our hearts must not be troubled. We must only believe in you. And today, dear Jesus, we do believe with our hearts. The only thing we're asking, dear Jesus, is to convince our minds to believe in your promises. Many of us are having many problems today. Many of us are sick. Many of us have lost hope. Dear Jesus, we pray and we say, please help us. Many of us are struggling with drugs. We are praying tonight. Break those chains. I pray for the families that have no peace tonight. May there be peace. May there be joy. And may there be love. In every family, I pray for every father in Ravensmith. Every mother in Ravensmith, every child in Ravensmith, that you bless them tonight. Dear Jesus, listen to our prayers. Forgive us of our sins. We pray and we ask all these things in the mighty and wonderful name of our Let everyone say, Amen. 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 Amen.